In this tutorial, I am going to discuss a LeetCode problem known as Happy Number. So let's go through the problem statement. So given an input number, we have to write a code to determine if a number is happy or not. And what is happy number? Starting with any positive integer, we have to replace the number by the sum of the squares of its digits, and we have to repeat the process until the numbers equals 1, where it will stay, so where it will end, or else it loops endlessly in a cycle which does not include 1. So we have two conditions: either the number ends at 1 or else it loops endlessly in a cycle which does not include 1. So those number for which this process ends in 1 are happy numbers. For example, so if the input number is 1, so let's do the sum of the squares of its digit. So 1 square plus 9 square, so it is 82. And again we have to repeat this process with this number 82. So 8 square plus 2 square, it is 68. Let's repeat again. So as it is, so we have not reached at this, I mean we have not reached at 1. So let's repeat this process. And if we repeat, if we do the square of 6 and 8, and if we do the sum, it is 100. And now let's do the square of 1, 0 and 0, and let's do the addition, it is 1. And if we do the square of 1, it is again 1. So the number stay at 1, or it will end at 1. So it's a happy number. And now let's take another example so that we can understand this problem better. So the next example is, so the next input number is 20, and now let's do the sum of the squares of its digit. So now we get 4, and only one digit is present. Let's do the square, and it is 16. So now let's repeat the process again with this number. So 37, so again 58, now 145, and let's say 1 square, 4 square, 5 square, it is 42. Now please pay attention. So 42, if we do the squares of 4 and 2, so it is 20. So we have started from 20, and now we again reached at 20. So there is some sort of cycle. If we reach at 20 and again we start with 20, again we reach at this point 20. So we keep endlessly in a cycle if we don't handle this condition. So this is the problem statement. Now you understand the problem. So what we need to check, and what's the else condition we have to handle in this code. So now let's think how you can solve this problem. In this problem, the tricky part is to detect a loop. So we have to make sure that the process of doing the square of digits of a number and repeating the same process again and again does not loop endlessly in case if the number is not a happy number. So we have to make sure that we detect a loop. So now let's assume the input number is 19, and we have to check whether a number is happy or not. And when the number is happy, when it ends with 1. So if it ends with 1, it means it's a happy number. So what we can do is we can run a loop until the number is not equal to 1. And in this loop, what we can do is we can do the square of digits of a number, and we can repeat this process until the number is not equal to 1. And so in this process, we have to check that we don't go into a loop endlessly. I mean, somehow we can detect that now we are going into a loop. We have to return false that this number is not a happy number. So what we can do is we can use one data structure, additional data structure, to keep the square of digits, the number we obtain by doing the square of digits of a number. So we can keep a set. So let's assume a set. So why we are using set? So the lookup time in set is O1, and also set only contains the unique element. So whenever so set does not contains duplicate number. So we can check if the number is already present in a set, then we are going into a loop. So we can return a false that this number is not a happy number. So let's visualize it. So we run a loop while number is not equal to 1. So 19 is the input number. So the value of n is 19. And let's declare one variable current and sum. In current, we assign 19 and in sum, we assign 0. And we run this loop while current is not equal to 0. So what we are doing in this loop is we are doing the square of digits of a number. So so initially the value of current is 19. So here I get 9, and then what I'm doing is I'm doing the square of this number and adding with sum variable. So sum is 0, and when we do the square of this number and add to sum, it is 81. And then I'm reducing this number. So let's reduce it. And now the number becomes 1. So current is still not equal to 0. So this time the remainder is 1. And the previous value of sum is 81. Now let's do the square of 1, which is 1. And let's add 1 to it. So it is 82. So it is 82. And let's divide 1 by 10. Now it is 0. So we came out of this loop. So is 82 present in our set? No. So it is empty. So initially when we declare a set, so it is empty. So no, 82 is not present in a set. So we reach at this condition, and the new value of n is 82, and let's add 82 in a set. So again we go again in next iteration, the value of current is 82 and sum is initialized with 0. And then what we do is we do this process while the current is not equal to 0. So let's do the square of digits of a number. So again we repeat this process. So now we get 2 here and we do the square. So sum is 0 and square of 2 is 4. So the number is 4, and let's reduce it. And when we reduce this number, it is 10. So I mean 82 is divided by 10, so it is 8. And current is not equal to 0, so let's what we can do is, so let's extract the remainder. So the remainder is 8, and let's do the square of 8, it is 64. So and what's the previous value of sum, which is 4. So let's add 64 to 4, and now the new number is 68. And when we divide this 8 with 10, it is 0. So we came out of this loop, and we are checking, is the number 68 exist in a set? No. So it does not exist in a set. So this condition is skipped, and the new value of n is 68, and we add 68 in a set. So still we are not in a loop, so we continue our process. So this is 68, and again the sum is the initial value of sum is 0, and now again we have to do the square of digit of this number. So now let's say it is 36 and 64, and now if we add them, it is 100. So I have already explained this process, so that's why I'm skipping it. I'm adding this, and it is 100, and we came out of this loop, and we are checking whether 100 exists in this exists in a set. No. So new value of n is 100, and let's add in a set. And also this condition runs until the value of n is not equal to 1. So n is 100. So now the new value of current is 100. So the new value of current is 100, and sum is 0. So again we do the square of this number, and this time we get 1. So is 1 exist in a set? No. So now the new value of n is 1, and we added 1 in a set. And in next iteration, when we check this condition, is n not equal to 1? No, this condition is false, and we came out of this loop and we returned true. So in this case, we returned true. It means this input number 19 is a happy number. And if we run in this case, now assume if the input is 20, then we keep all the numbers in a set, and when we repeat the process, we detect a cycle through this set. I mean, the number is found in a set. In that case, we return a false. So now let's see the main method. In this main method, what I'm doing is I am assigning a number to this variable, and then I am calling this method is happy and passing this number, and it will give me whether this number is happy number or not. So let's run with this input 19, and let's see if I run it. So 19 is a happy number. So let's run with 20. So 20 is not a happy number. We have already discussed it. So let's run it. And now if I run this code, you can see 20 is not a happy number. So that's it for this programming tutorial. And for more such programming videos and tutorials, you can subscribe our YouTube channel. You can visit our website, which is https://webrewrite.com. And also, if you know any other approach to solve this problem, you can let us know through your comments. And don't forget to like this video. Thanks for watching this video.